Hi, my name is Nick Stasulis, and I'm a hydrologic technician with the main office of the New England Water Science Center. In this screencast, I will discuss some of the common issues identified during field review of midsection measurement data collected in Section by Section Pro. A very common issue with Section by Section Pro data is a lack of angle correction or incorrect use or misunderstanding of the software's capabilities. In Section by Section Pro, there are two options for angle correction. The first is magnitude velocity method, which requires the user to manually measure and enter the flow angle for each vertical, similar to a AA measurement. The other velocity method is Y velocity, which requires the user to hold the ADCP at a fixed orientation to the tagline, and is typically only used for ice measurements. When using magnitude, inconsistent or irregular angles are due to an incorrect measurement or entry of the flow angle by the user. Ideally, these inconsistencies would be identified during data collection and addressed then. During review, these angles could be confirmed and/or modified in the software if needed. In this case, the manned cableway was skewed over the channel, and the angles entered by the user are consistent and reasonable, even though they are fairly large. Also, when collecting data, it is a good practice to record the heading of your cross-section when using an ADCP with an enabled compass. This cross-section heading can be useful for comparing the ADCP heading, mean flow direction, and correction angle. With Y velocity, inconsistent or irregular angles are likely due to the user not holding the instrument at the correct orientation. Since the software assumes the ADCP is held at a fixed, known orientation, any deviation from this orientation would result in an apparent flow angle. It is fairly common with Y velocity to see very inconsistent angles from one station to the next, usually attributed to the user misaligning the ADCP from station to station. Again, these are hopefully identified during data collection, as Y velocity angle errors cannot be corrected during playback. Another issue that data reviewers commonly see is large changes in temperature during data collection as the ADCP hadn't equilibrated, especially with the StreamPro. OSW Memo 2010.07 requires an independent temperature comparison for each ADCP measurement, and this includes midsection data. Ideally, these equilibration issues would be prevented by the independent temperature check obtained before the measurement. The unit temperature is easily identified in the tabular data on the left of the screen during data collection and during playback. Scroll through the stations and look for large deviations in temperature, which is the case in this ice measurement. The speed of sound can be computed based on a measured river temperature in the processing dialog, but this fixes the speed of sound for all verticals, even if the actual river temperature varied from bank to bank. During review of data in Section by Section Pro, you might see a single depth cell, usually at the very bottom of a vertical, that is clearly at a different velocity magnitude than surrounding data. This can be the result of only a few ensembles of the many collected at that vertical having cells at that depth. These depth cells tend to have erroneous data and can be screened easily using the Good Ensembles in Cell setting in the processing dialog. In most cases, changing the setting to a value between 2 and 5, 5 requiring 5 valid water velocities at that depth before using the depth cell in the average, will screen the invalid depth cells but not remove other valid data. If the erroneous depth cell remains after changing the setting to a value of about 5, consider using other thresholds to attempt to remove it. Section by Section Pro will only use an ensemble to compute the vertical's velocity if the ensemble has a valid depth. If the ADCP is having difficulty determining depths, there may be a significant amount of ensembles marked bad, which can be seen in the Good-Bad Ensembles field. If this occurs, consider changing the water depth source from bottom track to manual. If the ADCP cannot obtain any valid depths, you will need to conduct depth soundings during data collection and enter that depth. However, if the ADCP is obtaining occasional valid depths, the Section by Section Pro mean depth for the vertical may be entered as the manual depth. By entering the mean depth as the manual depth, all ensembles will have a valid depth and all ensembles with water data will be used. If manual depth is used, the source of the manual depth must be documented. When reviewing data, be sure the extrapolation method is set appropriately based on the deployment and based on the river conditions, and ensure the same settings are used for the entire measurement. The extrapolation method can also be changed for each vertical if needed. Also, be aware that the exponent can only be changed in one place, the processing dialog, and this exponent is applied to all verticals. Another mistake users make is not using the appropriate extrapolation for their method, like using a standard power-power fit for an ice measurement where no-slip should be used. A separate screencast will cover review of extrapolation methods in more detail. When using the midsection method with ADCPs, it's important to select the appropriate references, and a fairly common mistake is the improper use of these settings. In the processing dialog, ensure the reference is set to ADCP. It should not be set to bottom, as this could introduce errors in moving bed conditions or places where bottom tracking is difficult. Also, ensure the discharge method is set to midsection, not mean section. If you are using a unit with a vertical beam, you can change between the vertical beam or bottom track depths for each vertical, though it's best to keep the depth setting consistent for all verticals unless there is no one depth reference that is error-free. Possibly the largest source of error and uncertainty with all midsection measurements is the use of a poor cross-section, improper stationing, and use of an instrument not appropriate for the channel conditions. When reviewing the data, consider how a different cross-section or instrument might improve data collection. During data collection, ensure your stationing defines the river conditions and flow, and insert additional stations if needed. When possible, use an instrument and deployment that is appropriate for the depth and velocity conditions you'll be measuring in.